Today's fun-filled adventure is more fretwork, but we're heading into the Martin guitar. This is going to be a full-on fret dressing, leveling, crowning, polishing cordozal. But you saw most of it, I think, probably if you watched the Hofner episode, but this is a little more intense and a little more thorough than just cleaning up the frets. We're going to level the whole board. Cheers. First thing we need is coffee, and lots of it. So the way we start this one out is with a big old blue magic marker and one of my little protector covers that goes over the frets. And we're going to paint all the frets blue. Just same idea as you use layout dye in a machine shop. And stand by, time to paint them blue. Cool part about this is you get to sniff good old magic marker. You gotta love that. So I guess you can see the frets are blue. Whoops. Hope you can see that. So I'm going to put new sandpaper on my beam. That's the leveling beam that I'm going to run across the frets to make them all even. This is 120 grit. Sticky back. 3M products once again. Okay, this guy's all loaded up, ready to go with a nice new piece of paper. This is filled with rice to give it weight. So we don't push down and grind along. It's just the weight of the leveling beam that's going to take the tops off of these. So with each pass, the blue is removed. And I can see where the fretboard and the frets are least level, and get this all straightened out so it's going to play perfectly, we hope. I hope everyone's praying for me out there on this. Okay, that worked out great. Some of the frets, not much came off the top. Others, a little more did, but they're all the same now. There's many ways to level a fretboard, level frets. What I just showed you, is one of them. Many ways to skin a cat. But we're not going to do that today. We're going to do some fretwork. Once again, back to the nasty old fret file. Determining the right size burr for your file depending on the frets. I'm pretty sure we're narrow again on this, but we're gonna check. Yeah, that's beautiful. And remember, the file never touches anything but the fret wire. So you saw me do this in the Hofner thing. I'm not gonna do this all again for you, but you can go back to that. So I'm gonna get all the frets going on this, and it's gonna get strings pretty soon. Once the fretwork's done, it'll be time. Cheers. Once again, as I do this, I count every stroke. So what I'm doing is 10 passes on every fret. And then I'll flip the guitar the other direction and do 10 passes in that way. I find it, just because of the way your hand pushes the file across the frets, if you don't do it from both sides, it tends to be better here than it is there. I wanted to get right in there tight. Hopefully we can see the nice shape that the crowning file makes. So I've flipped the guitar the other direction. Now I'm going to do the same thing, crown them from this way. That way I'm sure I'm even both sides. The diamond fret files work so good. These files work great in this area because there's no danger of doing a big across the guitar. You can go in both directions. So that's why these are fantastic tools. So we made the frets. If you're looking at the side, here's the dots of the fret. We leveled them out so they sort of look like this. Right. Then we recrowned them. This is sort of exaggerated, but what we've done is we cut those corners off. So there's a nice surface at the top for the string to ride on. And that's what it's all about. Oh, I wanted to go handheld and get a shot of those spanky frets. So that's it, leveled, crowned, polished. Cheers.